Yes. Yes. Oh, yes. This book has changed my life.
That's no lie.
Did you know that there are Spassky communes all over this country where Spassky-ites live and practice his teachings?
So, you want to live there?
It might be nice to visit.
Come on, we gotta go to school.
I'll be right down. I have to practice my breathing.
Come on, ladies. Education is a privilege, not a jail sentence. You should be grateful to have an opportunity to better yourselves. Very well. I'm leaving. Goodbye.
I don't think they're listening.
I'm beginning to have that feeling.
Saturday the 11th, debutante ball. All proceeds for the new clubhouse.
Invitation, Gov?
No. Just want a donation from me. What's with that club of mine? They know I got five girls. One of them's got to be eligible for this.
I'm sure it's just an oversight.
It better be.
I'll get the car around.
Hi. Where's Rose?
In a room. Breathing.
Still breathing. Is that a new dress?
He noticed. She made it herself.
No kidding. It's really pretty.
A bit of spring simplicity for the casual mademoiselle. The price a mere $49.99.
Cost us $6 plus labor.
Now you're talking like a Foley girl. And you are so talented.
You think so?
Absolutely. Hi, Rose, don't you think Diane's dress is nice? Maybe she can make you one.
Clothes mean nothing to me. I think they're stupid and unimportant.
What do you want to do, go around naked?
In a better society, we would.
You mean like the spastics?
Spassky-ites.
I don't get it. 2 months ago, she was a happy-go-lucky kid. Then wham! She reads a book by a crazy dead Russian. I don't know her now.
It's just a phase.
A phase? I think she got hit on the head with something.
It'll pass.
I hope so. Have a good day at school.
What is that? I know it has a slight odor.
Well, tell me, what is it?
Only if you promise not to react.
I promise.
It's called Dagba.
What's Dagba?
Fermented sheep milk.
Oh, thanks. Thanks a lot. I'm sorry. I bet it's very good for you.
It's a perfect food. Vladimir Spassky lived on Dagba in Siberia.
Can I borrow your sugar?
Sure.
Thanks.
The Matthew Taylor's pretty fine, isn't he?
I didn't notice.
Yeah, I noticed you didn't notice.
Matthew, you haven't called in 2 whole days.
Amy, come on. No Lambify is rushing this week.
I'm a dead man.
What's the matter? They put me in a fast class.
Now she's back up with kids her own age.
What is that?
Rose is eating her dagba. It's made out of sheep dip. Sheep milk. Sheep milk. Sorry.
I know I'm gonna mess up.
Relax, I'll help you study. You will, Rose? Because I really don't want to have to go back with the short people.
This is terrible. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I can't find anything. Daddy said I could have my own gown made because next to a wedding, the debutante ball is the biggest event of a girl's life. But I sincerely can't find a style in my life.
That's because you're not looking in the right place, Hillary. Diane, stand up, please.
Stand up.
What are you doing?
See the dress this girl's wearing? Made it herself.
Where? In shop?
She can make your debutante dress for half the cost of those rags you're looking at.
I sincerely doubt that, Marva.
Okay, but soon the price is going up. Because, see, my girl is getting calls from people like Coco Chanel and Oleg Cassini. Isn't that right, darling?
Yes. Coco, Oleg, they just won't leave me alone.
Tell her to practice on Rose.
And those clothes, they're even starting to smell.
Let it ride.
Let's face it, she can't help it. She's only a half-breed.
Oh, that's right. She's half sukiyaki.
Half sukiyaki, half slob.
Think fast, Hillerman!
Patty, don't!
That's all right, Hillerman. It stinks, but it don't stain!
Nice drive, Stu. Like he's got his cold on this whole Foley.
I'm gonna need every nickel with this debutante ball coming up. 10,000 this year. Why?
Come on, your Amy's worth it. You gonna help us out, Nick?
10 G's, huh?
Maybe you'd sure appreciate it.
Well, I've been wondering why I haven't gotten an invitation.
What do you mean?
I just got a letter requesting a donation. No invitation. How come I got 5 girls?
Yeah, but aren't they orphans?
So what does that make them, boys?
I think what Lowell meant was that, take my Amy, for example. She's been reared from birth for the sort of social life that goes with being a debutante.
Besides, it's way past the deadline.
Look, let's cut the baloney. What you guys are saying is my girls aren't good enough for this, right?
No.
Yes. Look, I know you guys. I've had to deal with people like you my whole life. If you don't have the right name, the right background, you're out.
I wouldn't put it that way.
You want my 10 G's? You got it. Just sign up my girl, Diane, for this debutante.
All right, as long as you feel that she's up for it.
Are you kidding? You will find a sharper 16-year-old around. She even makes her own clothes.
She's 16?
Is that a problem?
Well, Debs have to be 17. That's the rule.
Now listen, you guys, don't hand me...
No, Nick, we can't bend that one.
17. Rose is 17. Okay, I'll go with Rose.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. Why shouldn't I be sure? She's the right age. She's a girl. She's a daughter. What else do you need? It's Rose.
Rose, it's no use. I'm never gonna know this stuff.
Patty, you've read the chapter. Now, the great Spassky teaches us that knowledge comes to those who relax, clear their minds, and think of nothing. Now breathe. A
Blacks don't think of anything. Now, what was the chief reason for the construction of the Panama Canal? Patty?
What?
What's the answer?
I don't know.
What?
You told me not to think of anything, so I didn't.
That's so you relax.
Rose, I am about to offer you the opportunity of a lifetime.
I like to have it long, so in case I trip, I don't hurt my knees, because they bleed sometimes. And don't make the sleeves tight, because I have to be comfortable if I'm playing jacks.
Anything else, Your Highness?
Yes, I need a pocket for gum.
Listen to this. Nick just told Rose she has to be a debutante, and is it hitting the fan? A debutante? The whole idea is revolting. It's against everything I believe in.
What do you believe in? Walking around like some kind of a zombie? Dressing like you're going to a funeral every day?
I have a right to live my life my way.
What life? You never go out. You never go to parties. All you do is come home from school, sit in this room, and breathe. And look at this room. Look at it. All that beautiful furniture I bought you.
Vladimir Spassky says furniture is decadent.
Who cares what Vladimir Spassky says about furniture? 2 months ago, nobody heard of the guy. Now he's your decorator.
I find him very uplifting.
Well, I find him very depressing. The man lived in a hut in Siberia. He walked around in a basket and slept on straw. And that's only when he could get it. And do you know why he didn't live in a house? And why he didn't have nice clothes and a lot of furniture?
Why, Mr. Know-it-all?
Because there was none available. Have you ever heard of a Siberian shopping center? It doesn't exist. That's because Siberia has never been popular.
That's why Spassky picked it. He hated shopping.
Rose, you're letting your life be run by a guy who exists on fermented sheep milk. Some horrible stuff called Digby.
Dagba!
You know it?
I eat it.
You eat it? What's it taste like?
I can tell you what it smells like.
Spare me.
I am not going to be a stupid debutante.
All right. I am through arguing with you. I'm not going to let you pass it up. This is too important for you. You're going to show them you can do it. You're signed up and that's it. End of discussion.
What's happening to you, Rose?
Can't you see he's trying to help you?
How? By wanting me to be some dumb debutante?
No! By showing you that we're just as good as anybody.
That we can do the exact same things as Amy Hillerman.
Rose, you gotta show them who we are. We're all in this. At the orphanage, you always gave us strength. Always told us not to be afraid.
That's what you always told me.
Excuse me. It's time for my Dagba. Come on.
Put 'em in line.
beautiful.
This just in. A circus van has overturned on the Harbor Freeway. No one was injured, but three gorillas have escaped. And now for the weather.
How are you feeling?
I'd rather be with those gorillas.
Hello? Hello. I'd just like to welcome all of our lovely future debutantes and tell you that we will be introducing them formally to the press in a few moments. So in the meantime, please enjoy yourselves.
A smile would be nice.
I don't feel like smiling.
Then fake it. You can't do it for me, do it for Spassky.
Hello, Nick.
Hey, how are you, Stu? This is Rose.
Hi there.
Well, Rose, you seem happy.
Yes, I am.
Have you been meeting a lot of people?
No, I haven't.
You and Amy must go to the same school.
Yes, we do.
Good. Well, it was nice to see you.
Yes, it was.
Forget the smile. Eat something.
Oh, what is it?
Caviar.
I hate it.
Next time, I'll make sure they have Digby.
Dagba.
Digby, Dagba. It's still garbage.
Waiter.
What are you doing?
Hey, Nick. I don't suppose you have that check with you.
Yeah, sure, Lowell. Be right back.
What am I supposed to do?
Mingle. Talk to people. They speak English here.
The first week, you eat mainly hard-boiled eggs. It's horrible, but I lost 11 pounds. Truly an incredible diet.
You know, Vladimir Spassky says dieting's moronic.
So you're fat. Who cares? It's all ego.
You, a debutante? Must be a joke.
Stow it, Marnie, before I shove an hors d'oeuvre up your nose.
There you go, Lowell.
Thank you, Nick.
Excuse me a second. How you doing?
Oh, I'm a big hit.
See, there's nothing to it.
Oh, look, I need some air.
Sure, but come right back. They're going to start the introduction soon.
Your carburetor. Can I take a look?
Yeah. Sure.
Cut a rag?
Here.
Oh, shoot.
Ah, that's too bad.
Okay, start it.
Yeah.
Your carburetor needs a cleaning.
Great, thanks.
Eastman. Christine Fletcher. Rose Foley. Rose Foley. Sheila Gray.
Why is she fixing a car? She knows she's going to get all greasy.
Maybe to impress some dear boy, perhaps.
She's not interested in boys. It's against her religion. Why doesn't she understand that I'm trying to do something good for her?
I think she's insecure, Gov. She's frightened.
About becoming a debutante? What's the big deal? All she's got to do is show up at the ball and look cute.
Well, not really, Gov. It's quite a bit of training. Poise, manners, the niceties. Years ago in London, I was apprentice butler at Miss Grimley's school for young ladies. They come there twice weekly for years to prepare for their coming out.
That's what Hillerman was saying. So you know about this stuff?
Well, only from observation. Miss Grimley did write a book, however.
Well, and that's what we'll do. We'll train her. We'll buy that book.
But we only have a week.
So we'll give her a crash course. Clapper, I'm determined she's going to do this. We're going to show them what a Foley girl can do. Our young lady should walk. All right, Rose, let me see you walk.
Walk? I know how to walk.
Why is everything an argument with you? Just do it. It is important to keep the back straight, the head up, and the toes pointed slightly in. You're not keeping your back straight.
That's the way I walk.
Well, you walk wrong.
Well, fine. You show me.
All right. Head up. Back straight.
Toes slightly in.
Of course.
Looking good. Hubba, hubba.
Piece of cake, piece of cake.
Oh, watch an old pro. Straight back, Patty.
Wait, I'm a great walker.
Toes in, Mickey, Mickey, toes in.
Toes in,
don't
Mickey.
Don't wiggle as much. Be coordinated, guys.
Heads up, girls, heads up.
Who's
talking? Oh, that's my clapper Barbie. Okay, everybody.
Like that.
All right, that's enough. Sit down. And you, Sloucho, get up and walk. Come on. Walk, walk. Papa, I think she's got it.
These places make me nervous.
Well, it's important to train them to combat conditions. The gown we bought is going to look great on you.
You see how much they get for chicken here?
Never look at the prices, just order. Oh, there are the tailors. That must be his kid. Well, I think I'd like to have the Chateaubriand. How about you?
How do I look?
Great.
How's my hair?
Terrific.
Excuse me.
Wait. That isn't the mechanic.
Huh? Oh, yes.
I'm Matthew Taylor.
Rose Foley.
You fixed my car.
Oh, well, I really don't know that much about cars.
Well, I'll call you, okay?
Okay.
Your number?
Oh, Klondike 54203.
What happened to my shirt?
I still have it.
Keep it.
He wants to see me.
Who?
Matthew Taylor.
Didn't I tell you we can do it? We're going to show them all. They're going to be falling at your feet.
Oh, Nick, I'm so happy.
Matthew, you are escorting Amy Hillerman to the debutante ball, aren't you?
Of course. I'm also going to ask Amy to become my Lambda Phi lady, to accept my fraternity pin.
I'm sure your father and I couldn't be more pleased.
So, how was everybody's day?
Hard. We learned too much spelling.
Oh, poor baby.
Listen to this, Gov. Amazing. Staying in the wooded foothill areas, the three gorillas continue to elude capture. Eyewitnesses last report seeing them in the Bel Air area.
That's near us. What if they come here?
Well, let's see. Well, give him a bunch of bananas and a cup of coffee.
Coffee? Get out of here.
Let's you and me make popcorn. Gorillas really love popcorn. Come on.
Popcorn? You're crazy, too.
Forget today. I need a drink.
Help yourself.
The test covers three whole chapters through World War I.
Is that so hard?
It is if you're retarded.
Hey, a learning disability is not retarded. You're a smart kid, so get off that.
Okay, okay. I need Rose for this.
Well, you can't have her. She's got a date with Matthew.
Again?
Yeah, again. She likes him. Look, if you need help, I'll help you.
Okay, but you gotta use a Spassky system.
Spassky system?
We sit on the floor, we breathe like Spassky-ites, then you ask me questions while I think of nothing.
That's the Spassky system? Well, we're going to use the Foley system. We sit on nice chairs, we breathe like normal human beings, I ask you questions while you think of everything. We begin in 5 minutes.
This is going to be tough.
Spassky system.
Matthew Tate, do you mind if I use your telephone, sir?
Sure, go ahead.
Thank you. An interesting house.
Thank you.
Those columns out front are Greek Revival, right? Chuck, did you get a date yet? I know her, you snake. She's faster than a speeding bullet. Nah, any reservations? I'll slip Mario a 20. Right. I'll get Rose.
Well, Matthew, we really haven't had a chance to get to know each other.
Well, I feel like I already know you, sir. My father says that you are quite a businessman.
Oh, thank you. You interested in business?
Well, not yet. I have time.
Well, it doesn't hurt to start early. You know, a part-time job in the summer, maybe.
I've already made my summer plans.
Oh, yeah? What are you going to do?
Kratos are sailing to Jamaica for some serious scuba diving, then thought I'd come home, swim, work at my backhand, that sort of thing.
I see.
Rose. What can I say but wow? No, no, make that double wow.
Thank you, Matthew.
Well, we gotta travel. It's been a pleasure talking to you, sir.
Same here.
Bye, Nick.
Have a good time.
I hope you like veal, because this place makes the best.
Oh, I adore veal.
So what do you think of young Master Taylor?
Truthfully speaking, strikes me as a perfect little snot.
I was hoping it was just me.
What a family. Who's that one with the medals?
Hiram Taylor. He fought at Gettysburg.
Well, it's so impressive.
Rose, I don't want to talk about them anymore. I want to look at you.
Oh, Matthew.
Let's go to the pool house.
Huh?
You are so beautiful, Rose. I am wild about you.
The pool house.
I definitely want to see a lot of you.
Honestly, Matthew?
Honestly, Rose, come on.
Matthew, may I please speak to you for a moment? I'm sure that Rose will excuse us.
Sure.
Mother, I told you, I am taking Amy Hillerman to the ball. I'm also pinning her tomorrow. So stop worrying.
Well, you certainly are giving this Rose person quite a rush.
She's very attractive, and she's fun. Nothing serious about it. Dad, you know what I'm talking about.
Matthew, I told your mother, these Oriental types can be very exotic. Afraid when I was over there, I wasn't a very good boy either.
Well, if that's all there is to it, I shouldn't have worried. But you realize, Matthew, with your dreams of political office and the Taylor family name, you've got to be very careful. Worthing seems nice, but you never know what they're thinking.
Don't worry, Mother. I'll be careful. I promise.
What do you think, Clapper?
Oh, she'll look beautiful, Gun.
Rose, your dress game.
I hate him!
What are you doing? Rose! What, Rose?
Why did you do this to me? Why didn't you just leave me alone?
Rose! Gotta do something. I can't let him get away with this. Did she eat anything?
She wouldn't touch anything.
I could hear her crying all night.
All that time, that phony was gonna pin Amy Hillerman. So what did he want from Rose?
Oh, the pig.
I can't let me get away with it. With their high and mighty garbage. You dig down deep enough with these blue bloods, you find out that half of them started out as bums or criminals or worse. Wait a minute. That's it.
What you gonna do, Gov?
I'm gonna make a little phone call. I got a friend in Salt Lake City who owes me a favor.
Salt Lake City?
Remember where we rented those Halloween costumes?
Mm-hmm.
Reeves Wardrobe, 3rd and Culver. Why? I think we also have an obligation to do something about this.
Do you have a plan?
It's crazy, but it just might work.
The knights of the Lamb Defy and their ladies please form the traditional semicircle.
Hello, Nick. What did you want to see us about?
Well, I think you might know Lowell.
Yes. Well, that was very unfortunate, but it's for the best.
You know, before you judge people on their background, I think maybe you ought to take a look at your own.
What do you mean?
I've got this lawyer friend who represents a very interesting institution. It's called the Genealogy Library. They've got records on almost everybody. So I jotted down a few items that he dug up about your ancestors. You know, not the ones you have hanging on the wall here, some of your other ones. Like, for instance, your great-grandfather, Wilfred Taylor, the Indian trader. Now, look, he wasn't one of those guys who sold whiskey to the Indians. He sold Indians.
Foley, I think I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
Yes, this is really very gauche.
Gauche? You want to hear gauche? How about your great-great-grandfather, Malcolm, who was in show business? He was a sideshow geek, but he had a very interesting specialty. He ate live chickens.
I've seen the bright and slowing light that shines from my dear Lambda Phi upon a lady and her knight to make them one, a sacred tie.
Okay, this is it. Let's do it. And remember, no prisoners.
Frederick Taylor, embezzler and turncoat. The list goes on. Lewis Taylor, arsonist and wife beater.
Amy Hillerman, this is a sacred moment. I am about to offer you the fraternity pin, which will entitle you to all the rights and privileges of a lady of a knight of Lambda Phi. Do you accept?
I do.
Mildred Taylor, otherwise known as Madam Millie. Let's see what else we have here. Aha!
What's that? They call the police.
Get away from you, I'll brain you, ape or no ape.
It's me.
Who's in there?
It's me, Lava.
Lava, are you crazy? Get out of here. What are you doing? Get out of here. Which one are you?
Patty.
Patty, the cops are coming. Get down. Get up. Go, beat it. Diane, right? Beat it before the law gets.
Okay, Nick, see you later.
Beautiful. You won't believe what those girls just did.
No, I was just coming to get you.
What's the matter?
Rose is leaving.
Leaving?
Says she's going to be staying in some sort of Vladimir Spassky commune.
Rose, what are you doing?
Don't even try and talk me out of it.
Look, I know you've been through a rough time.
What do you know? You don't know.
What are you talking about? You think I haven't had to put up with stuff like this in my life? You think they just opened their arms to a poor Italian kid from Hoboken? I have to fight for everything I got.
The odds are different here. I can't win.
You can't win if you don't fight.
Fight for what? To be Matthew Taylor's little fling? Some dirty joke for him to laugh about with his beer buddies?
Look, look. Rose, I'm sorry I forced you into this debutante business. Maybe I did it more for me than I did it for you. Maybe I made you fight my fight. But look, you don't need them. You're beautiful and you're sensitive and you're intelligent. You're a winner. You don't need him and I don't need him.
Get out of my way!
Rose! You mean to tell me that you're gonna run out on me and the girls because some insignificant little twerp rejected you?
I don't care about Matthew Taylor.
Then why do you want to run and hide in some nutty commune?
Because I don't care who you are, where you come from, or what you look like.
And you're saying we do, is that it?
No.
Then why do you want to leave us?
Because...
Why?
Because...
Why?
Because... She was a Nisei, an American-born Japanese. She had her Matthew Taylor, too.
He was a GI in her internment camp. I guess she felt she loved him. I was the result. They transferred him out of there. She never saw him again. And her father made her give me away. The day after, she stepped in front of a train.
When did you hear about this?
2 months ago, a woman who was in the camp with her sent me a letter with this locket, my mother's picture inside. At least now I know what she looks like. Oh, God!
I wish I could make this pain go away. I can't. All I could do is love you.
I love you too, Nick. Nick. I gotta go to that debutante ball.
What?
We gotta go. I can't let them think I folded.
Who cares what they think?
I do. I want Hillerman and Taylor and the rest of them to think I could pull off this debutante garbage blindfolded.
You wanna go?
Yeah.
All right, we'll go. Sure. We'll give that place some class.
Oh.
What?
I ripped up the gown.
I'll explain that later. But I just got an idea of what to do about the gown. I'm dead, kid.
Mary Young, presented by her father, Patrick Young.
Rita Zachary, presented by her father, John Zachary. I believe that completes our introduction. So now, I'm sorry, we have one more. Oh, my. Rose Foley, presented by her father, Nick Foley. Fathers, dance with your debutantes, please.
Sir.
Wait. What's your name?
Sam Novak, sir.
What are you gonna do this summer, Sam?
I'm working for my father. Construction.
Sounds like hard work.
Yeah, but how else am I gonna learn the business?
Okay, Sam, go ahead. My girl.